All right, folks, welcome back. This is March 17th, 2021, ICT Mentorship Lecture. I'm going to start with a little bit of general commentary. I'm going to give you some lessons on cross-pair analysis, and I'll review the trade I had in Eurodollar, New York Open, pre-FOMC. All right, so we're looking at the dollar index. This is our daily chart. This order block in here may be the next draw on liquidity. We have a small little volume imbalance in there as well, so be mindful of that. If we lose this imbalance down here with the order block has my interest. So it needs to lose this before that, but we might get a little bit of a bounce in here. We'll see what happens as a result of that. Bearish order block here on the daily chart. You can see we've worked off that level and attacked the sell side liquidity here. Range expansion should take place to send us into this bearish order block. All right, so here's that daily bearish order block just extended in time in the hourly chart. Banged on it several times in here, and in FOMC today, price releases out of its multi-day consolidation and then attacking sell side liquidity here. All right, and again, 15-minute time frame really shows the consolidation leading up into FOMC and a very quick repricing lower for sell side liquidity on the dollar index. Euro dollar. Sell side imbalance, buy side inefficiency. I'm looking for that to potentially close. If we lose this low, okay, if we lose this low here, then all of this becomes a point of interest for me. But right now it looks like the market has went below here, tried to go lower, and has rejected. So we want to see it trade up to here. If it goes through this, next area of imbalance is up here, and that's the objective for the bulls. All right, here is the hourly chart for euro dollar. We had several buy side liquidity pulls here, here, and here. Small little imbalance up here on the sell side imbalance, buy side inefficiency. So this will be again an area where we'll look to see if it wants to trade up into that. Consolidation in here ahead of FOMC and then repricing. Minute time frame, euro dollar, buy side liquidity, order block in here, optimal trade entry. You saw this if you were in the Telegram channel this morning. I shared that example in here using internal range liquidity, and I'll talk about that when we do the trade recap. But optimal trade entry, trades back up in, fails to take out the buy side liquidity initially, consolidates, trades back down into bullish order block, and then repricing at FOMC. All right, so here's the 5-minute chart on euro dollar. You can see the low here that took out previous sell side liquidity here after midnight. So it trades down, rallies up, comes back down into this candle right here. Had the high of that candle noted in the Telegram channel trade example. This was the first touch and return to the order block right there. So I was using that so that way I didn't have to draw any attention to the projection block down here. Okay, so that's where it went to there. But I don't mind getting ahead a little bit early. It's not a big deal. But buying in here and then watching it drop lower. This is one of those signatures I like to look for. Like if it goes down into a discount, rallies, and then offers another opportunity to buy below a low, that's even better. So it trades down into the rejection block here. Rallies, comes back into the bullish order block there. Optimal trade entry. New York open. Price rallies up. Now, I only had a 10 pip objective, and the premise behind this whole week was to get you thinking on how to structure your first initial partial. Obviously, I'm not trying to push the idea of making your model just be 10 pips and entirely that's it, but it helps you frame the trade ideas on all aspects. Every trade has to have at least 1-to-1. That threshold is in every trade, or at least it should be if you're looking at taking a trade. So your first profit objective or partial can be 10 pips. This can actually graduate to 15 pips and then 20 pips. So this is how you start. You work with a small range like 10 pips and you try to get it every day. You're not trying to convince yourself that you at your level of aptitude is going to be able to do it every single day. But by practicing and doing it, striving to do it, will increase your tape reading ability. And what is tape reading ability? Watching the candles paint and forecasting where they may reach to next. That's how you practice. You forward test like that. You're not trying to do demo trades for the sake of making money. You're doing the execution just to reinforce the idea that you're buying as candles go down and selling short when candles go up. And you're trying to train yourself to do this without any emotion. You don't care about the result of the trade because it's not a profitable thing. It's a executional thing. And by time doing it, you will learn how to very easily, without any emotion, without any regard to missing out on a full potential profit if you kept the entire position on, take something off at 10 pips. And like I said, if you get good at doing this, then graduate to looking for 15 pips and then 20. And you just keep doing that. Now, obviously, you can't get to the point where you're trying to trade 100 pips every daily range because not every daily range offers that. Obviously, we've seen this week where it only took today's FOMC before Monday, Tuesday, daily range for Euro wasn't all that big. But the opportunity to be a buyer in here and taking 10 pips off as it trades up into this old low, I was buying it here knowing that 10 pips would allow me the flexibility of seeing even if we had another drop down into that projection block there. Market trades back up and fails to take out these highs. Now, this is important because any other time apart from being ahead of FOMC, I would have expected this to be ran through. But because it's FOMC at 2 o'clock in the afternoon New York time, I didn't anticipate these highs being taken out because Euro was being held in a consolidation. Now, how did I know that? Just look at your chart. Look at all the time frames, and you can see they've been holding that pair. It hasn't been wanting to go higher or lower. It's just being held sideways. That's important because it's the same thing that the dollar index has been doing. Now, if you recall, I've talked about this before. If the dollar index is ever held in consolidation, immediately you should go through your crosses. And euro dollar was being held in manipulation as well. So I was looking for a weak pair. Aussie dollar was a weak pair. That means it was going lower while euro dollar was being held in consolidation. So if you look at the pair name, euro dollar, and look at Aussie dollar, the pair name for the cross is euro Aussie. If you pull up euro Aussie on forex.com's data feed on TradingView, you can look at the contrast between how the 5-minute chart and 15-minute charts of euro dollar and that of the Aussie dollar was weaker. So that would mean that euro dollar would be bullish. So if euro dollar is bullish, but majority of it's because the Aussie dollar is the weak currency between the two in the cross euro Aussie, that means that any bullishness on euro ahead of FOMC is going to be short in delivery. And it means it's not going to try to trade outside the range. That's why I wasn't anticipating this here. But I was illustrating that even though it doesn't trade outside the range, you can still find 10 pip ranges. And then ultimately we trade over here on the older block again here, and then rallies and explodes up through with FOMC's announcement. All right, here's the daily chart for British pound versus US dollar or cable. This right here has my attention. We have a lot of buys hidden here, and we've had an attempt to try to go lower. Went below these lows on this low. Tried to go lower here, didn't do it. And now we have FOMC, and it just looks like it wants to trade up into this area. So we'll see how we trade here. Short-term bias for cable, I think, is reasonable for this daily fair value gap. If we lose Wednesday's low, the sell side liquidity here is going to be the objective. Pound dollar hourly chart. You can see they had a rejection block here, extending out in time, hits that. Now again, sell side liquidity rests below here, and we have buy side above here and here, and that's the fair value gap on the daily chart. Those discount to premium levels relative to its daily time frame. Okay, pound dollar 15 minute time frame, you can see just reaching down into the rejection block over here. Cut through all this. This was stop running, and then back into the key PD array over here. Trades up and rallies. I got a question from one of the members. Is a rejection block essentially the head and shoulders pattern? Sometimes it'll look like that. Sometimes it won't. Sometimes it's simply just knowing that short-term retracement. If you want to be a classic chart pattern trader, clearly you can see this is the left shoulder, the head, and the right shoulder. Where will the right shoulder form? Well, if you have a rejection block and you want to use this type of pattern, then you can use the rejection block to zero in on where the right shoulder should form on an inverted head and shoulders pattern. If you don't know what an inverted head and shoulders pattern is, I don't like to teach it. I like to teach when it fails. And if you use my concept here with order flow and where the market's going to draw, I guess in a way you can use the classic chart pattern like I've taught many times in the past. Using how I teach order flow, if you look at classic chart patterns with that, they'll tend to work. But if you don't have order flow correct and you're just looking for patterns in price for the sake of patterns alone, you're going to fail and fail miserably like I did when I was younger. But if you don't know what the pattern is, it's not a big deal. You look at the low up to the neckline. Okay, so this low up to about here, if it breaks above there, it'll probably go that much from this low to this high in here. You don't see a high right now. It's just a range that I'm drawing out with my imagination from this high to whatever previous high over here was. It's just a measured move type thing. And I'm using a low, lower low, a higher low, and then projecting it higher. All right, now I'm going to teach you a little bit about cross pair analysis. Now this is important. It's a little higher level learning, but I'm comfortable teaching it because I think if you look at what I'm going to show you here, it'll resonate with most of you. The newer folks, probably not so much, but I promise if you go into mentorship deeper, there's other lessons that cover this and obviously a mentorship charter level. So here's a Euro Aussie 5 minute chart in the New York session here. So we had a nice run up, retrace, rally up, and then we're pulling back into optimal trade entry in here. So the point is this. All right, so while this pair Euro Aussie is bullish, at the time I was looking to take a long in Euro dollar, looking to do that 10 pip scalp, one for one at 1% risk, I elected to frame it with this logic here. So Euro Aussie is bullish, so that means one of these pairs is stronger. To make this pair go up, one of two things have to happen. Euro goes up while Aussie dollar is held in consolidation. Or Euro is held in consolidation and Aussie dollar is allowed to drop or go lower in price. That's what makes this cross go up. So what I did was I was going through the pairs and I said, okay, I want to trade Euro. So what's the best way of trading it? So what you want to start with, and this is algorithmic theory, so you want to be taking notes with this, if we are looking for a move ahead of FOMC or without FOMC factored, but I'm showing you how I did it today, you want to look at the FOMC holding pattern. So in other words, what pairs are being held in consolidation? Clearly, euro dollar was being held in consolidation in comparison and contrast to the Aussie dollar, and I'll show you those charts in comparison. But the holding pattern was for euro sideways, Aussie lower, which essentially will allow this pair to go up, euro Aussie. So euro Aussie shows bullish institutional order flow. So we go through the pattern of looking at the first pair, euro dollar. Well, it's neutral, so that means it's held in consolidation. The central banks are holding it sideways. If that's the case, then we know that Aussie dollar should be bearish. And when you check institutional order flow on its chart, it is going lower. It's breaking lows and highs are not being broken to the upside. The cross pair analysis is this. Euro Aussie is equivalent to going long New York Open, right here. Euro dollar is equivalent to taking a long, but only trading internal range. That means you're not looking for a breakout because it's not likely to do so. It's being held in consolidation. Aussie dollar is equivalent to taking a short in New York Open. So you can sell short Aussie dollar. You can go long euro dollar, but just know that you have to be using internal range liquidity for your targets because we're being held for what? FOMC. This is all going to change at 2 o'clock when the news releases. FOMC, the dollar is released, goes lower, all foreign currencies rise. That is algorithmic theory and how you use cross-pair analysis. Now let's look at this in relationship to the euro and Aussie dollar. Here's the 5-minute chart with euro dollar. Here's your propulsion block here. It trades down, rallies back up, and does not take the buy side liquidity here. Leaves it intact and holds the range. Trades back down into small little fair value gap. Rallies back, small order block again. It trades back into, and then you see that expansion at FOMC. Then it attacks the buy side liquidity. But it's being held sideways, okay? It's being held sideways. Even though it's making all these little short-term swings and you can trade those, it takes a nimble person to do so, but the relationship of the cross-pair analysis, when you look at this pair with Aussie dollar's going lower. It's being allowed to break lows, so it's bearish. So it's going lower when it is not being seen in euro dollar. Euro dollar is being held in consolidation. That's what makes euro Aussie go up. So the way you use this information is if you want to see a trending breakout move, the better trade is to sell short Aussie dollar in New York today. The long in euro has to be a very short-term internal range liquidity setup, not looking for a breakout. Now, I get asked a lot by my students, how do I know when the market won't go above old highs for a turtle soup or a run on stops? It's this right here. But obviously, it takes a lot of understanding, and you just can't say, well, it's one video and it completely summarizes everything, and I understand it completely now. You probably have 100 more new questions as a result of me touching this topic tonight. But just know that we teach more of this, and I haven't taught all of it. It's just a first introduction, really, throughout the mentorship content, because it's deep. It's a very deep lesson, and it's not something that can be shown easily, you know, one time in a video and say, okay, here's a 10-minute illustration and theory and concept, and now you know everything about it. It's not that easy, folks. And I am not in any way implying that you're not intelligent enough. It's just you don't know the things that I have to use to build up this logic that we haven't even touched on yet. But I think you can see from a visual standpoint, the logic that I've shown just tonight, how that helps frame and not let it be a guessing game. Okay, there is a technical science behind this. As much as the other folks in the world want to say that, you know, at some point it becomes, you know, useless, no. This is valuable intel. Like, this helps you determine. It helps me, clearly. And I'm giving you examples. I'm showing you every single day what I'm looking for and how it's delivering. So the tight wire act I'm doing is I'm doing executions without giving the best entries, because to keep doing best entries, people will eventually see what is mentorship, which is propulsion blocks, where they're at, the logic is why it should be traded there, and I can still pull out the setups and do what I'm looking for without getting all of mentorship level teachings or even examples. But I want you to think about how this helps frame when a market can be used to go long but not expect it to run out an old high, or for a market to go short and not to run out an old low, but also, more importantly, is to know which markets are going to be allowed to trend and have external range liquidity attacked. And what is that? We have the range here to here. It trades up and sells off. External range liquidity is the sell side here. Just like now, this low to this high, sell side liquidity below here is the external range liquidity outside this dealing range here to here. This high here at redelivered rebalance in here trades up into that consequent encroachment and then sells off and attacks the external range liquidity there. Whereas running from this low up to this high, relative to this high and this low, this dealing range, if you're counter trend trading and you're going long in here, looking for it to run back up to here, this is an internal range liquidity there because it's not taking out the previous range high. But if you look at how the euro dollar was maintaining its dealing range low and dealing range high and staying from where I bought here, taking my profits ahead because I did not feel that this was likely to go higher. So I elected to use the euro dollar. Now I could have easily did the Aussie dollar short for the 10 pip, but I wanted to ring in this opportunity to teach you cross pair analysis. I'm not teaching this on YouTube. I'm not going to teach it in Telegram. I'm not teaching anywhere but here, because this is the real mechanics that makes these markets move, how they dance with one another, what's the symmetry and or the lack of symmetry. When there is decoupling, what can you do with that decoupling? And it's this here, cross pair analysis. So hopefully you found this insightful, and until I talk to you tomorrow, be safe.